हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज मिस्टर सचिन खराड़े, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ प्लांट बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, नासिक. नाउ गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ टॉपिक ऑन माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया एंड इट्स स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन. सो वी विल टर्न टूवर्ड्स द बेसिक इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया. So the mitochondria are organelle with eukaryotic cell that produce adenosine triphosphate. We can call it as ATP, the main energy molecule used by the cell. So for this reason, the mitochondria is sometimes referred to as powerhouse of cell. It is a double membrane bound organelle found in cytoplasm of eukaryotic cell. So this is the short history of mitochondria. So the Richard Altman, who is the scientist who observed mitochondria first time in the year 1894, and the term mitochondria was coined by Carl Benda in the year 1898. So this is the endosymbiotic theory of an mitochondria. So the infolding the plasma membrane of an ancestral prokaryote give rise to endomembrane components including a nucleus and endoplasmic reticulum. So this is the pro-eukaryote. From that we can see the development of endoplasmic reticulum. So the second is, in the first endosymbiotic event, the ancestral eukaryote consumed an aerobic bacteria and that evolved into the mitochondria. So in third step, in a second endosymbiotic event, the early eukaryote consumed the photosynthetic bacteria that evolved into chloroplast. So the chloroplast and mitochondria was developed inside the pro-eukaryote cell. So the third step, that is modern heterotrophic eukaryotes that have photosynthetic bacteria, we can call it as a, it will convert into the mitochondria, and the modern photosynthetic eukaryote that having the chloroplast and the mitochondria. So the morphology of mitochondria by the various components, that is the size of mitochondria, which is ranges from 0.5 to 1 micrometer in diameter. And the shape of mitochondria is normally sausage shaped. In fibroblast, elongated and thread-like structure was observed. The number of these mitochondria in a cell, which is depends on types of size and functional state of the cell. So example, an average liver cell contained around 1500 numbers of mitochondria. The location of this mitochondria is cell with high energy requirement. So example, sperm tail, then muscle and the flagella. So the mitochondrial structure, which is divided into five parts. First one is the outer membrane. Then second one is the inner membrane space. Then third one is the inner membrane. Fourth one is the main part, that is Christi. And fifth one is the matrix. So we will turn towards one by one. So this is the basic structure of an mitochondria. So we can see the basic outer membrane, which is in blue color by outer membrane. Then the inner membrane, we can see the inner layer of this cell wall like structure, and the intermembrane space we can see by in between outer membrane and inner membrane. We can call it as a intermembrane space. So the DNA, which is suspended inside the mitochondria, we can call it as a mitochondrial DNA. So the ribosomes, which are also present on the Christi, and the liquid or cytoplasm like liquid present inside the mitochondria, we can call it as a matrix. So this is the basic structure of an mitochondria. So this is the detail of each part of this mitochondria. So outer membrane, which is simple phospholipid layer or bilayer, it encloses the mitochondria. So this outer membrane will cover all the components of mitochondria as like a cell wall. Then the containing proteins, structures called as the porins. So the protein structure, which is inside the outer membrane, we can call it as a porins. And the ions, nutrient molecule, ATP, ADP, etc. can pass through this outer membrane with ease. So the next part of mitochondria is inner membrane. It is freely permeable only to the oxygen, carbon dioxide, and the water. It contains complexes of the electron transport chain, the ATP synthase complex, and the transport proteins. So the presence of sophisticated ion transporters exist. So the several antiporin system exist, allowing exchange of anions between the cytosol and the mitochondrial matrix, which is the main function of an inner membrane. It is devoid of cholesterol and rich of phospholipid and cardiolipins. This is the structure of an intermembrane space, which is present inside the outer mitochondrial membrane and inner mitochondrial membrane. So this is the phospholipid bilayer structure of an outer membrane of mitochondria, and this is the inner mitochondrial membrane, which having the proteins to transfer the oxygen, water, and ions. So the next part of an mitochondria is the intermembrane space. The space between inner membrane and the outer membrane, we can call it as a intermembrane space, or we can call it as a O cavity. It has high proton concentration. The space between inner and outer membrane is approx 70 angstrom units. So the concentration is same as that of the cytosol. So the next part of mitochondria is the Christi. It is folded structure, or are fold of inner mitochondrial membrane. We can call it as a Christi. So Stahl particles or inner membrane spheres, which is present inside the Christi. So the Christi is covered with this inner membrane spheres called as Stahl particles, or the knob or heads. They contain proteins called as F1 portion and the F0 portion for and F0 portion. For ATP synthesis and ATO oxidation, it is mainly used. So the basic structure of these Christy you can see by the zoom. So this one is the F0 portion, you can call it as a tail, and this is the F1 portion, you can call it as a head. So this is present on the fold of this Christy. So the mitochondrial matrix, which is liquid part or liquid cytoplasm like a structure present inside the inner membrane of this mitochondria. So it is gel like consistency and dense, it is a dense and homogeneous portion of this structure. This is 2/3 of total protein of mitochondria. So it having the total 2/3 portion of the protein of mitochondria. So the mitochondria having some enzymes, ribosomes, DNA, mRNA, granules, fibrils, and the tubules. So the major enzyme include the enzyme involved in mitochondria, which is used to synthesize of nucleic acid and the proteins, and the fatty acid oxidation, which is also carried out. Then the TCA cycle, except succinate dehydrogenase, which is performed inside the mitochondrial matrix. So the double stranded conventionally closed circular molecule, it occurs in multiple copies, most usually remains attached to the inner mitochondrial membrane, stores biological info required for the growth and multiplication of mitochondria, can undergo replication and duplication. Human mtDNA, we can call it as a mitochondrial DNA, then not obviously autonomous, depends on the nuclear DNA. So the functions of mitochondria, which are listed here. First one is the energy transducer of a cell, which can synthesize of adenosine triphosphate, you can call it as ATP, by the Krebs cycle in matrix, electron transport chain system, and phosphorylating system, it is ATPase. So it has extra mitochondrial inheritance, that is mitochondrial DNA contains plasma genes, you can call it as extra chromosomal genes, which can inherit the traits to the next generation. It is also transmitted from mother to the offspring. So the synthesis of mitochondrial DNA, RNA, and protein brings about gene expression through gene duplication, transcription, and translation. So the synthesis of 13 different polypeptides in the human. So it is also site of several metabolic reaction. This metabolic reaction, which is very much important inside the living organism. So the outer membrane of mitochondria includes the following three metabolic reaction. First one is the oxidation of epinephrine, then the degradation of tryptophan, then the third one is the elongation of fatty acid. Then the inner membrane having oxidation, and the matrix having Krebs cycle, beta oxidation, detoxification of ammonia in urea cycle and the storage of calcium ion. So other functions of mitochondria is production of heat, non-separing thermogenesis, and the unharness potential energy of proton electrochemical gradient produced during the electron transport chain is released as a heat. Next one is the role in apoptosis. We can call it as a programmed cell death, which is very much important inside the cell. Then the synthesis of estrogen and testosterone, these hormones, which is very much important in male and female, which is synthesized inside the mitochondria. Then the role of neurotransmitter metabolism, which is also important part and important function, which is played by the mitochondria. Then the role of cholesterol metabolism. So the metabolism of chloroplast, which is carried out inside the mitochondria. So with this, we have seen the basic structure and functions of mitochondria, their various parts and functions, or various metabolic activity or metabolic reactions which is carried out inside the mitochondria. So thank you for listening. Thank you very much.